गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टार्टेड फिलोसफी ऑफ इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. आई होप ऑल द पॉइंट्स वर क्लियर टू यू. इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी विल कॉन्टिन्यू मेनी मोर फीचर्स ऑफ इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड देयर फिलोसॉफिकल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑल्सो. What is political philosophy of the Indian Constitution? Firstly, universal franchise. Universal franchise, general suffrage and common suffrage of the common gives the right to vote to all adult citizens regardless of wealth, income, gender, social status, race, ethnicity or any other restrictions, subject only to relatively minor exceptions. In other words, we can say Indian government is providing the right to vote to every citizen of India who has completed a certain age without any discrimination of caste and creed. From very early on, universal franchise was considered as the most important and legitimate instrument by which the will of the nation was to be properly expressed. Next, federalism. A federal government is one in which all powers of the government are divided by the constitution between a central government and the governments of the various units called states. But our constitution has a strong central because of special political conditions of India. The constitution provides for a uniform governmental structure for the whole country. Next feature is national identity. The factors that promote national integration and strengthen a common national identity is Indian Federation is a dual polity which is single citizenship. Our constitution provides a single uniform citizenship for the whole of India. Every Indian is a citizen of India and has the same rights of citizenship no matter in which state he resides. Secularism. The word secularism denotes a system which believes that religion has no part to play in the problems and events of everyday life. In other words, in India, secularism has adopted as a basic philosophy of Indian people. Secularism is a very much important feature of Indian constitution because Indian constitution is providing to their citizens a secular state in which everybody is free to follow any religion. And which points we consider in it? I'm describing, no one can force anyone to change the religion. By choice, everybody can do anything. Government will neither favor or discriminate any religion. Means state government is not in the favor or against of any religion. All religion are equal in the eye of law and state. Government will not interfere in the religious matter. There is no religion of the state. Rights should not be given on the basis of religion. Rights are assigned to the citizens according to their ability or their citizenship, not on the basis of religion. But some critics criticize the secularism of India. On the basis of these points, some critics criticize. First is, it is unwieldy. Means it's too long. Our constitution contains 395 articles and 12 schedules. No other constitution of the world has so extraordinary a size. In other words, the constitution is a complex document and provides a vast scope for litigation. As a result, the lawyers will have plenty of work to do. Some critics say the Indian constitution or secularism is unrepresentative, but we have already studied our Constituent Assembly was a mini India that representing all regions and a broad cross sections of the society. Moreover, the decision making process in general was marked by a sense of unity and a certain idealism. Makers of the constitution symbolized national aspirations truly and fully well. That's why we can't say this is unrepresentative. Third point is, it is alien to our condition. Means secularism is not a basic concept of according to Indian philosophy. Some critics criticize on this basis. An alien or non-Indian constitution. Some of the critics pointed out that no part of the constitution represents the ancient Indian polity, nor does it embody the Gandhian principles. Our constitution seems to have been affected and influenced by the Western constitutions. That's why this appears as alien. But this is a wrong approach. Our approach to life has always been absorptive without any rejection of the past. We should adopt all that the modern Western world has to give us to fulfill our needs. Indian constitution and secularism also have some limitations, like it has a centralized idea of central unity. It is also a part of Indian polity. It has no clear provision related to gender justice. Social economic rights are not a part of fundamental rights. All these are the limitations of secularism. But all these we have discussed about the not relevant for Indian constitution. I hope all the points are clear to you. This chapter is basically based on the philosophical concepts of Indian constitution. Maybe you can face any problem to understand the concepts. So you can call me and ask me your queries, or you can ask me your queries in a live classes which will be held in the coming months, I hope. Otherwise, you have cleared all the points. So, thank you and have a nice day.